after offer the rest to join them, we saw in the women's final, but that is perfectly possible.
Well, I wonder if this, like the women's, will be won not necessarily by the quartet that are quickest on paper, but by the quartet who have been drilled to exchange that baton slickly and quickly. Remember, there is no Russian team in this final. They failed to get the baton round as we look at the team in lane one.
So Singapore, Kang, Bing, Lee and Lim. All the men from Singapore have one more chance. They missed their key member though, Gary Yeo, in the semi-finals. He's not in the final either, so Kang, Bing, Lee and Lim again go with it. The Japanese, Yamagata, they're flashing 100 metre man with horror. Yonaguni and Izuka, the 200 metre runner here. The Ukraine, well, they actually set the world championship standard with their time in the semi-finals. The same four out again. Perishchuk, Simic, Bodrov and Kors. Thailand in lane four, Soen, Kronkov, Minapa and Chimdi. Pol, Zadansky, Kuch, Zasek and Krinsky going for them. The Canadians, Robertson, McKindy, Rodney and Effer. That's a sixth in the 100 metres final. Outside them, China with Yang, Gao, Yang and Wu. Outside the South Africans, Simbine, Brunchi, Trotter, and the double World University Games sprint medalist, Hananso Jobanwana, the first man since Pietro Manea in 1975, to take the double here at the World University Games. South Africa, though, have not yet set a time that would qualify them for the World Championships. Can they do it here? They're out there in lane eight, so they're going to have to do it blind. They won't see the rest of the field until they come off the final bend. But we saw that that was no handicap for the Ukrainian women in their final. Japan 2, Ukraine 3, Thailand 4, Poland 5, Canada 6, China 7, South Africa 8, the final of the 4x100m relay for men at the World University Games. Away we go then, and immediately off goes Simbine for South Africa, and he and the Japanese are getting away from the Canadian Robertson as the first change comes in. Oh, and the South Africans have got it all wrong, and they're well out of it now for Chinese takeover. But here comes the Canadians. McKindy now hands over to Rodney round the bend, and the Russians also not in this final because they dropped the baton in the semi-finals. Off then come the Ukrainians, and the Ukrainians could be up here for a double in the 4x100m relay. The women took it, and they cut across the line with Kors leading them in for a Ukrainian sprint double in the 4x100m relay. And Hananso Jobanwana comes across the line in a very disappointed last place, and he is unable to complete the treble here at the World University Games. It all went wrong. He just smiles up at the crowd saying, what can I do? It all went wrong before. But the Ukrainians take it, 38.56. Fantastic stuff from them. We're just waiting for the right results to come up at the moment, because for some reason the Ukrainians have now appeared on our screen, confirmed at 38.56. A big victory for Ukraine, the team in round two.
As the Ukrainians, like the Ukrainian women, enjoy the applause of the crowd. And that was another example of a very, very well-drilled Ukrainian team. And there are countries around the world, as I said yesterday, who could take a leaf out of their book. That is a very, very well-coached squad. It does not happen by accident to get the baton round that slickly.
Well, this was the trouble that the Canadians had. You start reaching, and the moment you start reaching and you look round, then you are finished. That has to be said. Kamieffa, I think, just goes off too early. And Rodney just can't catch up with him. But look at this by contrast. Look at that. The perfect relay technique. Man arrives, hand out. Man in front takes it. Doesn't look round. It's up to the man following to put the baton in the hand of the man running. And that's exactly what the Ukrainians did. I think actually the first two relay baton changes is what really won it for them. The third one, not quite as slick, but by that time, they're already in front. Japanese coming through, the Canadians going backwards, of course not as much as the South Africans, who completely messed up the first baton change.
And also that mess that the Canadians got themselves into, where they actually ran out of their lane and impeded China. They are still, the Canadian team, still in fifth place, but they were out of their lane, as you'll see on the slow-mo, and almost brought down the Chinese.
Although a disqualification will happen, but they can't do anything about China's results. Canada at the moment in 39-39, but that work could change, and South Africa as well might find themselves on the wrong end of the disciplinary. Just want to do